Light Channel Development, Empowerment and Leadership Initiative. T-Mark is my name. You are welcome to this week's episode. We've been talking about financial preparation, and last week I touched on how you can turn entrepreneurship into your own preparation for financial stability when you retire. Remember, all we are saying in this series of video is you need to create assets so that you get to the point where when you stop working for money, your money starts to work for you. Now, if entrepreneurship is not for you, either directly or indirectly, what are the other options that you have? Remember that this is building up from the standpoint of you are living on a budget, so you are able to save. And in that savings, which you should allow to accumulate over time, what can you do with it? One of the things you can do with your savings is to invest in real estate. One of my uncles used to tell me that God has not stopped creating people, but he has stopped creating land. And therefore, if you understand the simple equation of supply and demand, if demand is continuing and is increasing, but supply remains largely the same, even the waterways that are being claimed is still part of the finite creation that has been done, then you have an idea of why real estate will be a good line of asset. But I need to sound some notes of warning. If you live in the third world or in a country like Nigeria, please be very careful when you are doing real estate investment. Remember that if you are not careful and you do not go through your diligent due diligence, and I say that again, if you do not diligently carry out your due diligence, you may run into trouble. And what should be the ultimate thing you are trying to do with your due diligence? You need to be sure that you have the right title to whatever real estate investment you are making. Check with the families. Check with the government. Even in checking with the government, check from the different sides of the government institution where such records can reside. I have been a part of a construction company for a couple of years now, and I have seen how even getting some confirmation from government may not be sufficient, where there will be another level of information in another part of the government institute that you will be shocked will come out later when the shit hits the fan. Therefore, due diligence, very, very important. Secondly, before I go, you need to then remember that I said that what you are supposed to be focusing on is how to create assets. An asset is whatever pays you. Now, if that equation holds right, then it means that just acquiring a land to build a house in which you are going to live is not necessarily the same as creating assets. Can you see what I'm saying? Because if you move into the apartment and that's all that you've built, of course, you have a roof over your head. Extremely important. Give you stability, gives you grounding. But then when you need to change your car, will you take the house to the car dealer? Or when you need to pay for your hospital bills, you carry the house and pay the doctor or pay the hospital? No. Therefore, if you are thinking real estate for retirement, over and above whatever you are trying to do for yourself as your own accommodation, it must be something that pays you. A real estate that you are putting into use to generate annual, daily, weekly, periodic returns. It may not even be something you have to construct. Imagine if all you have is a piece of land in an area where parking space is very scarce and very expensive. all you may need to do will be to turn that place into a parking space, and every day you make money. It could be commercial construction if you decide to go that route. It could be residential. It could be any use you decide to put it to. It could also be that in constructing your own accommodation, when you remember retirement, you may be deliberate to not just let your own structure occupy the entire property. You could build something on one side for yourself and something small on the side that you could possibly let out, which will then continue to generate income for you. But whatever you do, real estate is a good investment. But don't forget, it is not just about you having a roof over your head. It's about you having real estate that can deliver value to you. And in pursuing it, make sure that you do your due diligence. And on top of that, if you are not ready to occupy, either to build or to possess or to put to use, you probably want to think again before you acquire real estate, particularly in the third world. Because whoever occupies the land is the first person that owns the land. Everything after that can become a litigation. But let this go into the series of what we've been sharing. The first is that it could be entrepreneurship. And the second that we've shared is that it could be real estate. We will continue next week to explore more options that you could consider when it comes to how to make solid financial preparation for your retirement. Thanks for those who've written in. Thanks for the comments that we are getting. And thanks for the encouragement you have been sending our ways. We please request that you do more of that. And also, that you make it a date with us next week as we continue the conversation. Until then, T-Mark is still my name, D-Line is still the channel, and don't ever forget that all we are trying to do here is what? Make a little difference. Make it a date next week, and I hope to see you then. Bye!